Well, friends, today let us continue our discussion on valve timing diagrams in IC engines, the second session. At the end of this session, students will describe the term valve timing diagrams and will be able to explain effects of changes in the valve timings on the operation of the four-stroke diesel engine and two-stroke engine. Operation of four-stroke CI engine. It is similar to that of SI engine, except the differences discussed below. CI means compression ignition. The same four strokes are there: suction, compression, expansion, and exhaust. However, in CI engine, only fresh air enters inside the cylinder during suction stroke, and the fuel is injected at the end of compression stroke inside the cylinder. In case of SI engine, we have said air fuel mixture is sucked inside. For CI engine, fuel used is diesel, and the compression ratios are higher, much higher. In diesel engine, combustion occurs due to high pressures and temperatures prevailing at the end of compression stroke, which are higher than auto ignition temperature of the diesel and air charge. In case of SI engine, we have seen the spark is needed. Here, the temperatures are higher than the auto ignition, self ignition temperature. So, there is no necessity of any external semin source. Due to higher pressures, CI engines is heavier than SI engine. Similarly, thermal efficiency of CI engine is greater than that of SI engine naturally because of higher compression ratio. Now, valve timings for CI engines. Consideration for valve timings in CI engines are similar to those of SI engine. Mechanical and dynamic both factors are considered here. Objective is to enhance volumetric efficiency and facilitate the efficient operation of suction and exhaust. Now, inlet valve here opens 25 to 30 degrees before TDC, top dead center, and closes 25 to 50 degrees after BDC. Well, exhaust valve opens 45 to 50 degrees before BDC and closes 15 to 30 degrees after TDC. So, with the same consideration, so we are not going in details because already we have discussed in detail last time. And the valve timing diagram looks like this here. As you can see here, this is the TDC. The inlet valve opens earlier, so suction, so we start earlier and it will continue from here. Then the compression will start, so which will end here at the top dead center position. Already inlet valve is closed, exhaust valve is closed only. Then comes the expansion, it will continue up to this instead of up to BDC, because exhaust valve opens much earlier and exhaust stroke starts from here. So this will continue even after, say, this, to take the effect that that momentum, or I mean inertia, say, will drive the exhaust charges outside. Okay, so that is the, say, valve timing diagram for CI engine, four stroke compression ignition engines. Now, there is a term, valve overlap. What is valve overlap? Can you tell me? We have seen. Yes. Okay. It is the term which refers to a period when both the inlet and exhaust valve remain open at the same time. It may be around 15 to 30 degrees of that crank, so that is the time. If the overlap is excess, it may cause flow of burned gases through inlet valve and accept of fresh charges through the exhaust valve without doing useful. So, it should be optimum. Now, after studying the four-stroke engines, say, today we shall continue our discussion on operation of two-stroke engines. So, before discussing the wall timing diagrams, say, let us study the operation. In two-stroke engine, the engine cycle completes in two strokes or only one revolution of the crankshaft. The two strokes are expansion stroke and compression stroke. As seen in figure 2, we shall see the figure. Suction of air and fuel takes place in the crankcase through the inlet valve. So that inlet or suction occurs inside the crankcase instead of cylinder. As piston moves towards top dead center and by the end of compression. So combustion occurs at top dead center and expansion stroke starts pushing piston downwards. During the downward travel, piston uncovers the exhaust port first and exhaust starts. Later, transfer port is opened. Transfer port is one which transfers the charge from crankcase to the cylinder. So the transfer port is opened and gases from crankcase will rush inside the cylinder from opposite side as shown in the figure. We shall refer the figure. Now, due to typical shape of the piston and of the transfer ports, incoming charge moves to top of the cylinder and helps scavenging of the residual gases. During upward travel of the piston, initially transfer port is closed, later exhaust port are closed and compression stroke starts and cycle then is repeated. The cycle is completed in two strokes. So, let us try to understand this with figure. Yes. So this is almost end of compression stroke. So by that time this piston will uncover this inlet port. So inlet of either fresh air in case of CI engines or fresh air and fuel mixture will take place inside the crankcase in case of SI engine. So that is the inlet. So this is position, say this thing. Now say here combustion will occur at the TDC and this piston will be driven, downwards. So it will move downwards. During its downward motion, here exhaust port will be opened and exhaust will start. After some degrees, this is the transfer port P. From crankcase here you can see. So as the piston moves further, say that gases from the crankcase, say they will rush inside. And due to this shape of piston, say they will move to upper part of the cylinder and it will help scavenging the residual gases or exhaust from the exhaust valve. Now as this moves downwards and reverses, say during its upward travel, first exhaust port will be, transfer port and exhaust port, say they will be, closed and compression will begin. So thus in two stroke only that expansion and compression, the cycle will be completed. Now before completion of the compression stroke, the inlet, now let us see the actual valve timings. Before completion of the compression stroke, the inlet port opens 10 to 20 degrees before the top dead center position of the piston that we have seen in the figure. The inlet port closes 15 to 20 degrees after TDC during the expansion stroke. So as the piston moves down, so inlet port will be closed. During expansion stroke, exhaust port opens 35 to 60 degrees before piston reaches bottom dead center position, BDC. So which in turn starts the exhaust of the combustion residual. And transfer port opens 30 to 45 degrees before BDC and it helps scavenging process that we have seen, say, in that diagram. So when the piston moves towards TDC from BDC, the transport port closes again 30 to 45 degrees after BDC and stops the scavenging process. Then say that exhaust port will be covered, and during the movement of piston from BDC to TDC, exhaust valve closes 35 to 60 degrees after BDC, and pressure inside the combustion chamber increases due to start of the compression stroke, and the cycle repeats again. The air fuel mixture in case of petrol engine and air in case of diesel engine is transported to the cylinder during the opening of the transfer port. If we see the valve timing diagram of two stroke petrol engine, so this is the top dead center position. Now here it is cyclically completed only in two strokes. So you can see here ideally this is the expansion stroke starts here and it should have completed here, but here exhaust port opens. Now here instead of valve it is called as port. Okay, exhaust port opens and exhaust starts. So at somewhere here, this is TPO, means transport port opens, and it said that will help scavenging. So scavenging, that is driving out the exhaust gases. So it will continue, say up to here. Now transfer port closes, so scavenging will be finished, but that exhaust is still going on because exhaust valve is open. And then here at this point, say both valves are closed, so the charge which is admitted inside the cylinder from the transfer port, so that will be compressed. So this compression will continue. This will continue. Now inlet port, so that will close here. Inlet port opens here, so that inlet means here the inlet inside the crankcase, so that will start here. From here to here, so this is the inlet position. Okay, so that way, so this is the valve timing, or you can say port timing diagram for two stroke petrol engine. In two stroke petrol engine, somewhere here the spark is ignited, so before the top dead center. Now this is valve timing diagram of two stroke diesel engine. The timings and say port openings, all these are almost similar. Of course, they will change slightly from engine to engine and its speed and all these things. But instead of that spark ignition here, there is a fuel injection, and fuel injection is not instantaneous. So that supply continues. So fuel injection starts at this point and it ends up to, continues up to this here, it ends here. Okay. So this, but everything else, so that is same. Now references for this session are taken from the book of Mathur and Sharma, then web pages mechanicalbooster.com, and say this figure is taken from this source for that IC engine, operation of two stroke IC engine. I thank to all these seminar sources, and I thank you all, say, for the patient listening. So thank you.